What assets to include in a will? Let's pretend we're talking to somebody who like has never done an estate plan before, never created a will before. So like what is a laundry list, and give concrete actual things that everyone should think about.
So the will's just a document. Mm-hmm. So there's many roads to get.
So that's the question.
Not having a plan to having a plan. The will's one of the ways to get there. The will is designed to convey, and when you die, there's things that are in your name. So like your house, if it's titled to you, your personal property, your car, any bank accounts that are just in your name, really anything that's just in your name. And I say just in your name repeatedly because because it not being just in your name is another factor to consider. So when we sat down to make a will, I want to see everything that's in your name. Mm-hmm. But I also want to look at assets that are not just in your name. And when I say just in your name, so it can be assets that are jointly owned with someone else. So if you own, like my husband and I, we own a house together. So that's just not mine. If I were to die, it actually goes automatically to him. So while I own it now, when I die, it's not going to be part of my estate. It'll be his house.
So jointly owned things do go in a will, or they don't go in a will?
They won't be transferred through your will. Okay. If it's jointly owned with right of survivorship.
Right.
With right of survivorship is the operative term. And most things with real houses or bank, any jointly owned bank account, like 99.9% of them are jointly owned with right of survivorship. There are state laws that actually govern allocation of them in theory. But things like with beneficiaries on them, so you have like a life insurance policy, mm-hmm. that's not technically part of your estate unless you make the estate the beneficiary of it. Or you leave the beneficiaries blank. But if I have a life insurance policy now. I'm using my plan. So I have a life insurance policy now. When I die, my husband's listed as a beneficiary. So right now it's a contract between me, the insurance company, and my husband. So that when I die, they give my husband money.
Right.
That's not part of my estate.
It's not part of your estate.
And same for like any account we have a beneficiary on it. So I have a brokerage account. My husband's listed as the beneficiary of it. While it's just my account right now, when I die, it now becomes his account. Mm-hmm. So certain things will not be part of your probate, will not be part of your will, but they'll be part of your estate.
Gotcha.
So you just kind of want to make sure you kind of globally look at it. And also the final thing with your will is if you have children under the age of 18, the will is the only document
that you can use to give them to someone else.
Exactly. You nominate a guardian for your kids in the will so that if both parents die in a common disaster, which is the most likely scenario for this, then both parents' wills would hopefully name the same person to be the guardian of the child, or else you've created a really dumb legal issue.
So people come to you thinking, okay, all I need is a last will, right? As soon as I knock this out, this is taken care of, and then I'm good, right? Mm-hmm. And so like this question is assuming the premise of that's everything that is an estate plan. There's no such thing as an estate plan. It's just a will. And so as long as this will is taken care of, then everything's done. What you're saying is that that's not a last will and testament. It's not just a will.
It's just addressed by having just a will.
Yeah.
You are dangerously close to having that crazy lady being at your probate court trial.
Right. So instead of just having a will, you're saying, okay, look at it as a whole picture, right? Think about your life insurance policies. Think about everything that you jointly own, because a lot of that can just kind of transfer to those other people without having a will.
I want to know about every single thing that has crossed your path financially that you have some control over. But
what list of assets would you kind of want from them?
Yeah, we know about your real estate. We want to know about your bank accounts, your insurance, your retirement accounts, your brokerage accounts, anything from a bank or financial institution or an insurance company.
What about a car?
Cars, sure.
Yep. What about a boat?
Yeah. Yes.
What about my old lawnmower? It's worth about $200.
No.
Could you put an actual dollar figure on it? Obviously, this isn't legal advice. This is entertainment advice.
You should tell me about anything that's worth at least $5,000.
$5,000. Okay.
Anything you think is valuable.
Well, yeah. And that. You should also tell us about stuff that's valuable in terms of it meaning a lot.
Yeah, exactly. So both the resale value and the sentimental value.
Yeah. So like if there are specific things that you want to do, basically, you know, when it comes to personal property, if you don't want it to be sold and then the money from the sale given to someone.
Or the kids fighting over it.
Or if you don't want the kids fighting over it, then you need to be specific about it and tell us where it needs to go.
If the book value of the item is less than what it would cost to talk to a lawyer about it,
Don't worry about it.
Well, worry about it now. Like, yeah. Mm-hmm. When you do the estate plan, you're like, if you know kid A and B are going to fight over it, make...
Or if you think they might fight over it.
Yeah. Either if you don't actually want the item, you can just mm-hmm. gift it to them now. Or if you do want the item, like, let's make a note to write it down.
So, but I think that's a super very interesting point, because, like, I think it might be common sense to you guys that, like, you know, a will is not like an itemized list of every possession in your house. Like,
that would
you know,
be a nightmare for both of us.
But I think that's some yeah. people. Some people don't understand that, right? Like, I didn't know that. You know, like if I'm making my will, there might be some part of my brain that's like, okay, great. I need to like take my mom has a collection of Christmas ornaments. That's like she has like 1,000 Christmas ornaments. And I think that she might – it wouldn't be crazy for her to conceive. Like, okay, I need to decide who's going to get this Santa
Each
Claus.
Each one of the ornaments?
Yeah. You know, I mean, like, I think some people actually think that. So that's interesting.
Long will.
And I think people make the mistake in that scenario of overestimate. If you are in that much detail, you're overestimating how much people want your stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've read multiple New York Times articles about people having trouble giving away stuff even.
Yeah.
Like, no one wants your couch. Yeah. I don't care how nice your couch is. When you're dead, no one wants your couch.
Something like a couch could become important. Like, if you have a kid or a relative who, for some reason, has a very strong memory attached to that couch, mm-hmm. then yes.
That would be such a relief as an estate lawyer that someone wants your couch and they'll have to hire a junk person to get rid of it.
So a will, what you're doing is you're taking the items that are really important to people mm-hmm. or important to you, and you're giving those away specifically. But for everything else, you're just calling it personal property.
Yeah, mm-hmm. and then you'll split
and
it
then
some way.
It's being split. Yeah, it's being split up into shares or something like that. It's called the residual. It's everything else that you haven't specifically talked about.
Yeah.
If it's an expensive item, if it's a valuable item, go from there. Or if it's something
but it's not a PlayStation.
That is important enough.
So over $1,000.
If you have a PS5 right now, maybe list that in your specific request.
So, you know, it's just what's valuable, what's important. Those are the things to do specifically.
Yeah.
Okay. Everything else is taken care of in like a lump paragraph.
And I think it's also – part of that is also just being realistic with your stuff. Like no one wants my forks.
Yeah.
Actually, people who visit my house make fun of, I have too many forks.
But the idea
but
of this,
no one wants all my extra forks.
We're trying to give people some actionable entertainment
advice. But
valuable
economically or sentimentally, let us know.
Yeah.
And if it's also one of those other things, like if it has a title to it, so just like a certificate, like with a car or a deed for your house or anything with a bank or financial institution, let me know. Don't get in the weeds on the personal property.
Right.
If you're in doubt about your personal property, just let me – just bring make a list of all your items you're concerned about,
mm-hmm.
and it should not be every single item. If your list is more than 20 items
– yeah, relax. I think that's super interesting too because, you know, one of the most common questions we hear is, you know, what do I need before I go – you know, if I'm going to have the best appointment possible with an attorney here, what do I need to bring to the appointment?
Over-include rather than under-include, but don't let this be a reason you don't meet. One of the few things I'm good at is helping people make decisions on this. Don't deprive yourself of the help making your list by waiting and trying to do it yourself. It's like me trying to prefix my sink before the plumber comes. Mm-hmm. Just let the plumber do it because I'll probably make it worse. It's like if you're not sure who I want to be the guardian of your kids, like, okay, I can help you work through that process. Like, I don't know what to include. I can help. This is our job to work through the process with you. So don't like let that be the end. Don't let that be the reason you didn't meet with me.
Yeah. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode of Let's Talk About Death and Taxes, let us know. Post a comment and let us know your thoughts. Guys, if you would like actual legal advice, send us a message. info@letstalkaboutdeathandtaxes.com is the podcast email. You can also give us a call anytime, 404-939-7562. Send us an email to our main firm email at...
info@scriberlaw or info@modernestateplanning, either.
Yeah, .com. Guys, have a great day. Thanks so much for watching.